What's going on, Neon Nation? Welcome back to the Neon Arcade for another video. Today we'll be going over the GOG Galaxy 2.0 beta, its features, and why it has the potential to make your life a heck of a lot easier if you have a large library of games spanning multiple launchers. Now, GOG was gracious enough to release the launcher to me, even though I did sign up for the beta on their website, but regardless, thank you to them for expediting the process. I believe the beta is rolling out slowly on a first-come, first-served basis, so if you did sign up for the beta, you should either have access already, or you will in the coming weeks. GOG Galaxy 2.0 is a powerful hub for all of your games. For one, it will import all your games from other launchers into one master library, and you will be able to see your friends' activities across all the platforms in this one convenient location. This includes console games, and although you can obviously only launch PC games from your PC, it's a nice feature for keeping your library in one spot and tracking your achievements across all of your platforms. Speaking of tracking, hours played is also tracked overall and from game to game, and you can customize your libraries by creating specific tags and adding unique backgrounds that originate from your game covers and art. You can also use this one launcher to chat with friends across your multiple platforms and to check their online statuses. Now, this is yet to be integrated into the beta, but this is something I'm really looking forward to upon full release. This will be huge in softening the blow for those who swap from console to PC, but still want to be in touch with their buddies from, say, Xbox or PlayStation. Leaderboards are also integrated into GOG Galaxy 2.0, which lets you take part in some friendly competition between you and your buddies in collecting achievements. Another great element of GOG Galaxy 2.0 and GOG in general is how they treat your privacy. With Galaxy 2.0, your personal data is never shared with third parties, and removing imported games and friends is a streamlined experience. The launcher does come with auto updates and the ability to roll back to previous game versions if there's a patching issue, as well as cloud saving and integration within all your devices. 2.0 will also offer matchmaking and online play for GOG Galaxy powered multiplayer games. Now, this is obviously still in the beta, and a lot of these elements are being added in with each subsequent patch, but here are my impressions of GOG Galaxy 2.0 after my brief time with it. First up, the design of the launcher itself is right up there with the best of them. It's a clean, easy to browse launcher and doesn't get bogged down with the clutter and myriad of information that they cram onto the screen in a launcher like Steam. You can organize your game into a variety of folders and browse them as you please. You have the achievement tab, which can be viewed by daily, weekly, and monthly achievement process. I like how they've listed achievements and playtime overall, adding the library under it and keeping these two elements together. By clicking on a game, it takes you to your activity feed within that game, where you can compare yourself to your friends on the leaderboard, and it gives you a brief overview of that specific game. Again, very similar to Steam, but with a cleaner, easier to navigate interface. Importing your games is an incredibly easy process, but I'd like to see them expand to other launchers and clients in the future, like Blizzard's Battle.net. As someone who spends most of the time I get to play games into Overwatch, I would like to see my progress and time tracked through that. You can customize your notifications to your liking, and they are developing an in-game overlay to allow you to be more connected to these notifications when in full screen. Now, if you are going to launch a game from Galaxy 2.0, the specific launcher tied to that game does open up first to run, so keep that in mind as it doesn't bypass that altogether. Again, the point of 2.0 is to be a cohesive hub to run in addition to these launchers. GOG Store is also attached to the launcher, so you can browse games on the fly and add them to your queue, again something fairly standard, although it's nice to see in their initial builds. Like I mentioned before, a lot of the functionality will be rolling out slowly, although the rest of the elements like GOG-based matchmaking and cloud saves in theory are going to be great additions when they're patched in. The biggest plus of Galaxy 2.0 is that it's going to save me the hassle of opening up all the various clients to play games. The central hub feature is the biggest reason I think most people will be using it, with being able to launch games and track all progress throughout all the platforms in one convenient location. 2.0 isn't something that you're going to use to replace your other launchers, and as you've learned by now, has more of a mutualistic relationship with them. It works well as there's no bugs or anomalies that I can detect, and it just makes sense to use Galaxy 2.0 right now, even in its beta form. This is my daily driver for launching games with little to no downtime. Thanks for watching, guys, and for more content, join Neon Nation by subscribing to the Neon Arcade.